Good day, fellas. I hope you are ready for your daily dose of skill, and today we are going to play with IS4. IS4 is top of the tree, and I was looking through the tanks which we can feature, and I think what we are going to do, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, we are going to feature IS4, and we are going to feature T150, because we never ever had T150 video, so hopefully in the end of this week you will get T50 video. Also, one more thing which I want to highlight, fellas, I am grinding field modifications in this way when tanks are top of the tree. So pretty much how my grind is looking like, I'm playing for 2 victories daily, right? 2 victories IS4, 2 victories STI, 2 victories KV4, KV3, T150, and so on. And the grind is actually pretty decent. Obviously, you are having the personal reserves activated and you are getting very, very decent experience. So yesterday I had a very nice game with IS4, very aggressive game, and I want to feature one game from yesterday, and overall we are going to play 2 live battles with IS4. I hope that makes sense, and you will see how casually is it possible to complete Heavy Tank 15 mission with IS4. And fellas, IS4 is not that bad. I am pleasantly surprised. Anyways, I do not want to spoil too much, so let's teleport into the action, shall we, fellas? And we are back into the action. So what do we have, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen? We have IS4 in the Lakeville against the tier 9 matchmaking. And as wrong as it sounds, IS4 is not that bad tank nowadays. Yeah, you might get a lot of heat spam, blah blah blah, I know, I am very very well aware of that. Yesterday, since we played with the heavy tanks, probably 80% of the ammunition which we received was a gold ammunition. But this is World of Tanks, and this is the world which we are living in, right? I need to grind those field modifications in easy way, and while relaxing in a way. Anyways, what is this tank up to, and what is so damn good about IS4? The gun handling of the IS4 is actually very nice, and it is amazing, I would even say. And a lot of people are underestimating IS4 armor. So you will see a super aggressive gameplay against many tanks, and we are not going to stop for a second. No, we are not stopping, we are going in. Skill, why would you do something like this? Well, this is one of the first games for me with IS4 after a while, and I really wanted to check out how armor is holding. And as many of you know, IS4 has a humongous side armor, and you can actually kind of oversight scrap with this vehicle. And look how many guns enemy team has. I mean, this is absolutely nuts in it, and it is insane. Unfortunately, we are bouncing a very well aimed shot into the shoulder of the Panzer, but what can you do? Cry every time, I guess. Luckily, another shot is going through, and once again, side scrapping. When you are side scrapping with this vehicle, it can definitely work, and Panzer has 0 Fs given. Panzer is blah 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 blah. Unfortunately, phase 1 is obviously punishing us for 400, but it doesn't really matter. I mean, looking into the maxi map, don't you think the situation which we are currently sitting in is not looking that great? I know Panzer more likely will penetrate me, and he is looking into the turret, so I'm trying to wiggle as much as I physically and possibly can, but that's okay. We need to finish this guy off, it is very important. Can standard round go through? Yes, it can, and phase 1 is trying to make a bit of pressure. But you know what? Once again, this tank is not that bad whenever you are side scrapping like this, and it is not so simple to penetrate it. So all we are doing a very nice 30 degrees angle or 25 degrees angle, and we are trying to beat the living crap out of the people which are peeking against us. Nothing too crazy, nothing unusual. Once again, side scrapping works just well, and hello there, Mr. IS7. You see, fellas, we are sitting already on 3,500 damage and 3,600 And 3,600 blocking damage. Let's make it 4,000. So yeah, pretty damn sick stuff. And as you can see, Škoda was struggling quite a bit against us. IS-7 have upper ground, so obviously this gentleman managed to penetrate us without bigger problems whatsoever. But it is completely fine. I am not complaining that much. Bad shot by me, because angling of the IS-7 was pretty damn ideal. But don't worry, we have some heat ammunition to rebalance the Soviet Russian armor. Easy game. Škoda. Yeah. That was pretty optimistic move by this gentleman, but it is how it is. Also, very funny thing which I definitely need to highlight, fellas. Our team is passive. I mean, our team is extremely passive in this situation. I mean, look at this madness, how the things are looking like. We have plenty of the heavy tanks, but they are sitting in the back. So we are pretty much holding a lot of enemies who are trying to, you know, punish us. But once again, it is not so simple. It is not so easy. And look at this beauty, fellas. When IS-4 is working, imagine that we are currently trying to complete the heavy tank 15 mission. We are sitting already at 11,000 combined. And once again, I did not saw that one coming, and I did not expect that this vehicle is going to behave that well, honestly. I did not saw that one coming, fellas. Our heavy tanks is still having a safe defense parameter. Once again, nothing what we can do about this. And I'm thinking, do I want to get involved in this situation? Do I want to go super aggressively or not really? Meanwhile, tier 9 Czechoslovakian heavy tank is going through the standard ammunition, but once again, it is understandable because angling from my side was pretty poor. And once again, we are sitting all right still. Believe me, fellas, we are sitting pretty well. Anyways, we have 6660 damage dealt. Well, Pyrosami minus zero, but it is all right. Can we make a bit more pressure there? You might think, and sure thing we can. Who will stop the almighty IS-4. So once again, for heavy tank lovers, if you haven't played IS-4 in a while, I would highly recommend to take this vehicle for a spin and just to check it out, how this vehicle is looking like, and you might actually have a great time with this. All you need to do, you need to understand, you need to make angles all the time. It doesn't really matter you are going frontally or you are going side scrapping way. It doesn't really matter, right? If you are going to make a nice angle, there is a humongous chance enemies are not going to penetrate you, and you are going to have pretty good stuff. Hello there, nice side armor, sir. Up 7,900 damage with IS-4. Okay, fellas, and you were afraid. Easy game. Obviously, we are becoming greedy at this point, and we want to get as much use as we possibly can, but it is kind of game over in a way. We are speeding the things up a bit, and I am obviously going for Char, Futur, and Leo 1 while relocating and while singing, or I suppose to say while saying. Anyways, look at this. 3 guns left. I am just going through the middle of the field. Leopard is not penetrating us with gold ammunition, which is always nice and always welcome. Can we penetrate Char Futur? Boom, for 100 damage. It is okay. And look at the score which we have. I would call it absolutely sick game. We have pretty much 16,000 combined if we are talking about damage and blocking damage. And for a mission to do, and for a heavy tank 15 mission, how much you need to do? 14,000. So as you can see, with a bit of luck, everything is possible and everything is fine. Although mistakes were made in the end, and obviously Leo is looking at us and he is thinking, ha! Easy game. Still a great game, even though we obviously died in the end of the battle, right? Obviously, our team is going to win this game because our team eliminated the last Enemy Survivor M60, and this is the score which we have. So this is a great game which I had yesterday. How about two live battles to see what this vehicle is all about and can it work? Let's teleport into the action or into the garage, I suppose to say. Let's go. Okay, we are back. So, fellas, once again, since I am grinding field modifications, I like to activate boosters for obvious reasons. And this is how I grind my stuff. We need two victories and we are going to get, the second victory is going to be 5x experience. So without further ado, let's go into the battle and let's see what matchmaking has to offer for us. This is the question. Obviously, whenever you are having matchmaking against the tier 8s, IS-4 is very powerful. Okay, we have Westfield, definitely not the best map for us, but this is what we have. Once again, nothing what we can change about this. What is the worst thing for us? The worst thing for us, enemies has the Chieftain, which can be the living crap out of pretty much everyone. So Kranwagen is dangerous, Chieftain is dangerous, Rhino is dangerous because Rhino can play hold down. What do we have in our side? Kranwagen and Super Conqueror. Enemies have one extra tank which can play hold down, and once again, this is a bit of the problem. But let's see, maybe we are going to make it work even though we have some disadvantage matchmaking wise. Although, well, look at this, there is enemy Fava which is not going to have a great time in this matchmaking. Okay, let's go. Let's see what we can do. Fellas. So first position which I am thinking about taking is going to be this one. We want to go up as soon as possible. And obviously we want to punish someone who is going pir like this. Because I have a feeling they are going to have a gentleman which is going to do that. I assume next shot is going to be heat shot. But before that, Rhino, how are you doing? Very nice. I am feeling great, fellas. Oh, hello there. It is such a funny thing. This Fava is tier 10. It is insanity, fellas. Everyone is shredding this gentleman like hot knife through the butter. Have you seen that? I was aiming for a hole and we actually managed to hit him in the horn. Unlucky Rhino. Although I must admit I know how it feels like to have a horn like this. Beautiful penetration to the IS-4. Nice. And you know what? It is looking way better than I initially expected. Very nice. Very good. Okay. How about if we would start crafting angle from this position? Kranwagen is looking directly at us, but this is not going to be easy for Kranwagen to penetrate us. And once again, I am just trying to annoy the Chieftain at this point. Our team is getting involved even more than before. Good. How about shot to Esterva? I thought I had intuition. Unfortunately, I do not. That's on me, fellas. I made a bit of mistake. I made a tiny mistake. That's fine. Chieftain is saying I will run. No, you won't run, buddy. No, you won't run. I know you would love to. I know that's the vision which you had in your head, but not today. Okay. Can we hit the Kranwagen side? I'm trying to craft the gun depression, but it is not so simple. Esterva is extremely powerful. How to counter Esterva? This is the other question. In fact, I don't really think we are going to go for Esterva for now. What we are going to do instead? Instead, we are going to go for this almighty Jack Pizda. We are having a nice angle. Unfortunately, I am missing my shot, but that's on me. It is completely fine. And Jack Pizda eliminated our gentleman from the game. We are aiming for a side. Jack Pizda is dead. Excellent. And now, can we spot this Esterva? It is very important, fellas. Kranwagen is running for his life. That's it. Okay, Esterva, how are you doing? Having a great time? Me too. Not the best shot from my side, and there is nothing what I could change about this. It was my mistake for sure. It was my mistake for sure. Angle wasn't great. Our object is going to ram this guy. And obviously Starve is thinking, holy bananas, and what kind of shithole am I sitting? Trying to yoink the kill, unfortunately failing. 10 to 5. Interesting. I truly thought we are going to get a bit more use of all this, but as you can see, the first battle which you have seen, all stars we are aligned for obvious reasons, fellas. And it is not happy. Not every single game you can get 15,000 or so, but it doesn't really change absolutely anything. We are trying to hit the 1-to-1B, and luckily we are hitting him without bigger problems. And now we should... I could eliminate this guy, but I would rather go for Leo because he has a bit more HP at this point. And I don't really care, even though he hit us in the face for once. We are trying to do some reverse side scrapping and game over. 3.1,000 damage, 1.6,000 assisting damage. We are sitting on 4.7,000 combined game. And we bounce at like 3,500, which is once again not bad by any means. Fine. We are accepting the first battle, and most importantly, this is victory, so we are going to get quite a bit of experience. And remember, if you have a premium account, you can use your doubles. It is very, very valid option for a very first battle of the day, aka 2x experience, because if I'm not mistaken, you are getting way more experience yourself. So let's apply this one, and 8,000 experience. Easy game. After that, we are going to get ourselves another field modification. And fellas, if you are wondering about the field modifications and you are not entirely sure what to choose for yourself, and you simply need some help, keep this in mind, fellas. We have field modification skill. What the flying F is field modifications, or what the flying F is index. All you need to do, you need to Google skill for L2 index, or alternatively just check out the description. And what you are going to see this page, and if you are clicking, let's say, on the comet, how the things are looking like, fellas, you are clicking on the field modifications and you are finding the modifications which I would recommend to go with a comet. Or alternatively, you can click on the Lansen and you can see the field modifications which I recommend on Lansen, or whatever else, Škoda T50. You get the point what I am saying. If you are struggling with it, just simply check out field check out the index. I hope it is going to be useful, and that's why we have done this page, right? Yep, let's go into the other game with IS4, shall we? I would love to get victory, so I would love to show this 10,000 experience game, or how much we are going to get, we'll see. No? Ooh, Prokhorovka, tier 9 one arta. Actually, half of the trouble. I definitely cannot complain about this. Also, why field modifications are so damn important, because you can have a different setups. For example, in this setup, I could drop improved hardening for ventilation, so I would have a bit more extra view range. Or alternatively, I could drop down the same thing for optics, so I could actually spot. You get the point what I am saying. It is important thing, and nowadays I think if you don't have field modification level 3, you are having a humongous disadvantage for yourself. It's just how it goes. It is just disadvantage, fellas. So for casual players, I sincerely apologize for this, but if you are not going to grind, then... Then a hashtag never lucky. Okay. What is the plan and how we can play this game? Budget. Hello there. What the flying? If you are thinking, comrade. I mean, I don't really think I can say something about this. Budget is just traveling all over the place. Obviously, he exposed himself a bit too much and he deserved to take one for the team. Now, if the things will go well, we should find the right angle to punish this gentleman. 3-2-1 now. Unfortunately, not penetration, but it is okay. And let's see. Bachet is trying to... This Bachet is taking the light tank role. I see, buddy, I see. Good. Whenever he is going to go for a next scouting run, I believe we should be able to smack him once or twice. Watch this, he's preparing to go for a scouting run, that's completely fine. And let's see, is he going for it? Sure thing he is, another shot in the face. Beautiful. I mean, this Bacchit is overestimating his powers. He's playing way too aggressively than he's supposed to. And I get the point, you know, I get the greed or the need for assisting damage, but it is not working in this way. I know I could go into the middle and I could farm the convoy, and probably this is what I am going to do. I am going to get a bit more involved in this situation. Oh, wait a second, Esterva. Can we hit him? Just going for a snapshot, unfortunately not a hit. That's fine. And now look at this. All we need to do, we need to wait until the convoy will get spotted, because whenever he will get spotted, we are going to start punishing him in the side. Wait for it, we have all time in the World of Tanks. Convoy, and hello there, mister. Quite bad shot by me, not gonna lie. I cannot blame the RNG, I cannot blame the convoy, I can blame only myself for misaiming the shot. One thing which is definitely worth to say, unfortunately, but amount of the ammunition of this vehicle is laughable. I truly mean it, fellas. Amount of the ammunition which this vehicle is offering is very, very low. No Russia. Fortunate. Once again, not great aim. Can we finish him off? This is the question. 3, 2, 1, banana land. Hopefully dead. No, he is not dead. At this point, obviously, I want to get a bit more involved, fellas. I believe this is completely understandable. What is happening in my head, fellas? I am thinking how to join the game and how to punish enemies even more. What is the position which we are going to take now? We are going to go through the middle like this. I know how dangerous this is, but in the same time, it can give a lot of use for us. So by taking this position, we should have an open angle to the gentlemen which are sitting there. Look at this. And we can actually spot them. We can get a lot of assisting damage. And this is exactly what we are looking for. Now the question is, this Esterva will try to shoot me or not really? I heard someone trying to shoot me. That's okay. Doesn't really matter. And once again, unfortunately, but we are not getting the decent enough angle to hit those guys. Wait a bit. Super Conqueror. Exactly what I need. How are you doing today? Boom. Unfortunately, not penetration. I think I spoke too soon about how good gun handling of this vehicle is. What do you think about this, fellas? Never mind. I'm taking my words back. Leopata is in the back and he's completely stocked, so he is not a threat for us, even though if he would penetrate us. Oh, yoy, stock T-54 Echo 1. Enemies are not going to enjoy this. Skill, what you are talking about? Well, you see, now our goal will be to escape from this position if it is possible. And in fact, I don't really think it is that easy as I initially thought it is. But you know what? We can actually be a bit aggressive against the Centurion action shit. At least that's what I'm hoping for. Once again, even though if they are going with a gold ammunition, we are playing with very, very well armored vehicle. And they are not going to have a great time by doing anything for us. Even though I know they have some guns in the back, it doesn't change anything. Now, watch this. We are going to try to escape moving backwards like this. Relax, take it easy, we got this. Escaping like this. And now, since we know what kind of guns do they have in the back, we are going to make pressure. Now, watch this.
Leo will get spotted, T54 Echo 1 will get spotted. And what will happen? We have quite a bit support in the back. What that basically means, that basically means whoever will get spotted. Schnei, 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 Schnei. And we know both of those gentlemen are stock, so they are lacking of the penetration. And since they are lacking of the penetration, this is not going to be very enjoyable experience for them. You don't believe in me? Watch this. Hello. Boom. Relax, take it easy, we are feeling completely fine. This guy is dead, now your turn to die. Take this one, it is okay. I can even turn my side to this gentleman. It is still okay. How about Bachet? Can Bachet die? Bachet is dead, beautiful. And this guy is pretty much already messed up. He cannot survive this. We are spotting him, so he is sitting in very, very, very deep shithole. And once again, stock tanks in the World of Tanks, it is not the most enjoyable experience, but nothing what this gentleman could do. Absolutely nothing. He could simply say, okay, okay, I get it. I'm going to take one for the team. Heat ammunition. I am out of the standards. Also, one more thing which is definitely worth to highlight, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen. Amount of the ammunition with this vehicle is not great. It is truly not great, fellas. Anyways, what do we need to do now? We need to get even more involved. We have, what, 7, close to 8,000 combined. And in a way, this is just a start because we can pack another 2,000 without bigger problems or Russia whatsoever. Beautiful shot into the grill. By the way, did you know a fact? Russian tanks, moving Russian tanks are way more accurate than sniping German tanks. Yeah, I know. Who could ever thought? Anyway, standard B and Foch. Hello, Mr. Foch, how are you doing? Can you please shoot me so I will spot you? That would be much appreciated. Foch is in the other side. We are hitting Foch. We are sitting on 8,600 combined. There is still standard B somewhere over there. Here we go. This guy is dead. We are getting half of the assisting damage. And Jeff. Okay. 9,000 combined, fellas. 9,000 combined. I think the best decision which we have done in this game was we were patient enough to figure out that they have in the back stock standard, stock Leopard, the T-54 Echo 2 or however their tank is called, and we knew they are not a big danger for us, so we simply went in front and we bam 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 bam. Look at this, 9,200 combined, and this is what I'm talking about. This is what kind of situation you can have with a 5x experience, and bonus, you can get 18,000 experience in pretty much one game if you are lucky enough, right? And this is what I am saying, field modification grind is becoming relatively easy and you are just going like this through the grind, honestly. And I did literally the same thing, fellas, with Chinese light tanks. I am not joking. Look at this. Even though I know the top tiers are horrible, right? But look at this. We are grinding through the field modifications and we have last field modification left over there and we have last field modification left over there. So once again, this is the right way to do the things. This is how you are getting the most experience by spending the least amount of time, if you know what I mean. Anyways, so what do we have? 2 battles with this tank and we had this is a good one. 3,500 damage, 3,400 assisting damage, 7,000 combined with IS-4. I don't know why people are complaining about IS-4 being bad. I do not know, fellas. Anyways, thank you very much for watching. I hope you had a great day and I hope you are enjoying yourself. And see you tomorrow, fellas. Thank you.